I ever need to create a wiring diagram for a data logger station that is already programmed and making measurements, but no wiring documentation is available, I have a few ways to do this. In this video, I will show how to use a spreadsheet to create a wiring diagram that matches my current system. The spreadsheet template I will be using is available for free download from the Campbell Scientific website. The file is an Excel template and works best with Microsoft Excel. Before I can create a wiring diagram to match an existing program, I need to know what sensors are connected to the data logger and the colors of the individual sensor wires. I also need to know which channel on the wiring panel each wire is connected to. In parts 1 and 2 of this video series, I demonstrated how to deduce which sensors connected to which channels based on site photos, sensor manuals, and the running CR Basic program. For this current demonstration, let's assume I've already verified sensor models, wire colors, and wiring. My CR1000X is measuring a CS301 pyranometer, a 05103 wind monitor, a TE525 rain gauge, a HygroView 10 temperature and relative humidity sensor, and a Taros 11 soil water content sensor. With this information, I am ready to create my wiring diagram. So I open the template called datalogger-wiring-template.xltx. The first step I take is to select File and Save As to save a copy of the spreadsheet. I will modify the file name to include my station name and today's date. I will also change the file type to Excel Workbook with file name extension XLSX. Across the bottom of the spreadsheet, I see multiple tabs for different models of Campbell Scientific data loggers. There are two tabs for each model. The first tab, named with just the model of data logger, is where I will enter the wiring information. The second tab, named with the data logger and the word text, is for printing and will be discussed later. I select the CR1000X tab to start documenting the system wiring. Now I change the station name to match the name of the data logger that I am documenting. Next, I need to clear the sensor, wire function, and wire color data that was already in the template. I do this by simply highlighting the cells I want to clear and pressing the Delete button. The upper left contains a section of cells used to create a drop-down list of wire colors. The first 16 colors are associated with conditional formatting rules that reference specific colors on the palette. It's best to leave those cells as they are. The last 5 cells are not associated with specific colors and may be customized to better match your system. My photo of the wiring panel shows that the CS301 pyranometer has a white wire connected to channel 1H, and black and clear wires connected to the same analog ground channel next to channel 1L. I select the cell next to 1H and a drop-down arrow appears. When I select the drop-down arrow, the colors are listed in the same order they are found in the section called Wire Colors. I scroll to the color white and select it. The white wire is the signal wire for the pyranometer, so I enter that information in the cell to the left of the color. I enter CS301 in the sensor column. Next, I want to add information for the two wires connected to the analog ground channel labeled Ground 1. From the drop-down menu, I can select black or clear, but I can't select both. This is a good place to use one of the custom colors instead. I'll go to Custom 1 and change the text to black and clear. Now when I select the drop-down arrow, I can see black and clear, and I choose that. There are no conditional formatting rules that reference the custom colors, so this displays as text only. Now I enter wire function and sensor information. I'll enter the rest of the wiring information I have from my photo and notes and then save the file. Now I'm ready to send my wiring diagram to a printer or to a PDF file. I do this with the Print menu in Excel. If I want a list view of the wiring diagram, I select the CR1000 Text tab and print that. I could also highlight this information and copy and paste it to a text document. Documenting the wiring diagram this way is very flexible. If I want to add additional notes or graphics to make the information more understandable, it's easy to do. Remember to update the wiring diagram after any change is made to the sensors or program.